The page layout section is where you will define the specs of your page. First, you'll be able to choose from a left-aligned page, a centered page, and a dynamic width page. As for the other page layout fields, you will see that as I click on an object and begin moving it around, you will be able to see the boundaries for the website. These are the values that we will be changing. Specifying a value greater than 0 in the top margin field will create a space between your website and the highest point of the browser window. For example, if I add a shape to the page and move it into my header all the way to the top, you will see that there is a white space between the top of the page and where this page begins. The content width will determine how wide you want your website to be. The content height will determine the minimum length of the page's body. This value rarely needs to be changed because the height will automatically adjust based on where you place the objects on your page. For example, dragging an object down will increase the height. Though you will not see the value increase in this field, your page height will still be as long as you make it via the objects on the page. The header height will determine how long the header will be. Like the content height, this will also adjust automatically based on what you have in the header. But if you do want the header to be smaller than the default given on the page, you will need to decrease this value. Finally, the footer height will determine the length of the footer. Like the header and content heights, the footer will also adjust automatically based on where you drag the objects, and you will also need to decrease the value if you want your footer height to be less.